Well, to answer that question, we're going to have to go all the way back to 1958, back to the legislation that originally created the space agency, NASA. So in that legislation, there's some forward-looking language that says, make sure that all the cool stuff you develop for space doesn't just get blasted off into the universe, but comes back down to the Earth in the form of practical and terrestrial benefits. I'm paraphrasing, of course, the legislation is actually a little bit dry, like legislation should be. Since that time, NASA has worked to get the technologies it created into the hands of the public. These become products and services, and they save lives, they improve lives, they generate income, they create jobs, they boost the economy, they increase crop yields, they make airplane travel safer, they make train transportation safer. NASA's everywhere you look. One example I like to bring up is the camera in your cell phone. That was actually developed at JPL. We were working on a lightweight, high-resolution camera for a satellite application, and that became the very first camera on a chip, camera in the cell phone. We've also worked on things like indoor agriculture, which is increasingly important as the world gets denser and people need access to healthy foods. During the pandemic, some researchers developed a ventilator that had fewer than 100 parts, none of which were required in the supply chain to make other ventilators. We gave that to dozens of companies all around the world to help save lives. If you check out spinoff.nasa.gov, you can find thousands of examples of how NASA is everywhere in your life. Thank you.